my dear children. Welcome back to Gurudev Online Class. My dear children, we have discussed three questions in previous class, right? I hope you have seen video. Before going to start today's session, today's class, let me revise what we have discussed and what we have learnt in previous class. I hope you enjoyed the three questions, right? Yes, here a king had three questions. So he thought that if I knew three answers for these three questions, I never fail in my career, right? So what are the three questions? Absolutely right. So I have written on board what we are discussed about the three questions in previous class, which a king got doubts, right? So let me revise what we have discussed. Yes, first question. What is the first question? Yes, first question. What is the right time to begin something? This is the first question. What is the right time? Being a king, what is right time to begin something in his life? And second one, who should a king listen to? To whom he has to be listened first? To whom he has to be? No, concentrate more. And third one, what is the most important thing for a king to do? Okay, being a king, what is his most important thing to do? Okay, in his daily life. So these are the three questions. Okay, it is a thought came to king. Okay, so what king he did? What he did? Just he sent some messengers. Those who carry a message to kingdom. He sent the messengers to his kingdom, and he announced that if I satisfy answer from the people, definitely I give some prizes for them. So he has been announced it. After a few days, many people came to king. Okay, and they told different answers. Okay, varieties of answers he got. What are the answers he got? So let me explain one by one. See here, first question, what is the right time to begin something? Here is a question. Being a king, what is the right time to begin something? This is the first question. He got many answers from the people. What are the answers he got? Some of the people came to him and he told that, my dear majesty, you need to prepare a timetable. This is a first kind of answer he got from the people. You need to prepare a timetable. Okay. And second one, second varieties of people came to king and they told it. So better you do one thing. It is impossible to fix a time advance. Okay, what you asked a question? That is, what is the right time to begin something? It is impossible to fix advancedly timing. Okay, when your turn comes, you have to go and you have to start work. There will be no timetable. It is impossible to fix advancedly. Some of the people told the answer. And among one more category of people came to the king and they told it, my dear majesty, better you have to be arrange a council of wise men and they may guide you when you have to be start your specific work. One more category of people came to king and they advised him that, my dear majesty, you have to be arrange a council of wise men. Council, already explaining previous class what is meant by council. Okay, you have to be arrange a council of wise men and they may guide you when you have to be start work to do something. You have to be arrange it. But one more category of people again came to the king and they told it, if there will be urgency, it is not possible to ask council when I have to start work. Okay, so one more category of people, council is not important to do something. So now the king got dilemma and he was distressed. He is unable to digest which choose the right way. Okay, he got dilemma again. And the second question, what is the second question? Yes, who should a king listen to? To whom he has to be listened first? To whom he has to be, giving more concentration? Who should a king listen to? So he got variety of answers. What are the answers he got? Some of the people told that, my dear majesty, you need to be concentrate on counselors. Who are the counselors? Those who guide everyday king, those are called as counselors. Those who have an idea about administration, those are called as counselors. Being a king, first you need to be concentrate on counselors. Some of the category of people told that you have to be listen first counselors. They are the most important in your life. Okay, and one more category of life, one more category of people came to king and they told it, my dear majesty, better you have to be concentrate on priest. Who are the priest? Those who are taking care about temples and also as well as those who are worshipping every time the god, they are called as priest. Better you have to be listen first to priest, because they may assume the future. Better you have to be listen them. That is a priest. Okay, and the king was not satisfied. Again, one more category of people came to the king and they advised that better you have to be listen first to the doctors, because the doctors are real heroes. They are nothing but gods. Better you have to be listen carefully doctors, because they are life savers. You have to be listen first. If there will be any famine or if there will be any doubt, if the people about to die, the doctors will arrive and they will save the life. That is why you have to be listen first doctors. Again, the king was not satisfied. Again, one more category of people came to the king and they told it, better you have to be concentrated on soldiers. These are the real heroes of your kingdom. Now your kingdom will be carried in the right way because of soldiers. That is why you need to be listen first soldiers. The king got again dilemma. He don't know what he has to be do. He was distressed again. He don't know what he have to do. Okay. He was thinking what I have to do. Again, third question. What is the third question? That is, what is the most important thing for a king to do? Being a king, what is the most important thing for me? He asked a question. He got several answers again. Some of the people they told that better you have to be involving attack. That is your most important thing. Always you have to be involving attacks for enemies. Okay. And fight. Being a king, always you have to be busy with fighting with others. That is your work. Okay. And some of the people again came to the king and they told that, my dear majesty, you have to be always involving in religious worship. Means always you have to be do puja, always you have to be do yagna, yagas. I think you would have studied in social. Veda, Vedangas, Yagna and Yagas. Being a king, you have to be involved in Yagna and Yagas. You have to be involved always in religious worship. Okay, so now the king, he was dilemma. He did not satisfy all these answers. So he decided that I need to meet a hermit who is known for wise man. Okay, now the king is decided to meet the hermit. He went to the hermit. While he was going, he went with the common clothes, okay, and he left horse and as well as his bodyguards somewhere else, and he went to the hermit hut. Okay, so hermit was digging the ground by his pad, and here the king went to the hermit and he asked three questions. My dear, I have three questions. I came you that you were clearing our doubt, but the hermit, he did not reply, just he was continuing his work. Okay, by his pad. Later, the king is looking at the hermit. He came to know that he was tired, and he asked him that, could you please give me your pad? I will help you. Then the hermit has given a pad to the king. The king was digging the earth. Again, he asked a question. Up to here, we are discussing. So, what is the final here? Here, the king asking a question to the hermit. Hermit, he was not replying, but the king was continuing his paragraph. Now I will read it, just you listen to me. Fourth paragraph. One hour passed, then another. The sun went down behind the trees, and at last the king stuck the spade into the ground and said, I came to you, wise men, to get answers to my questions. If you can give no answer, tell me so, and I will return my home. Fifth paragraph. Here comes someone running, said the hermit. The king turned round and saw a bearded man running towards them. His hands were pressed against his stomach, from which blood was flowing. When he reached the king, he fainted and fell to the ground. The king and the hermit removed the man's clothing and found a large wound in his stomach. The king washed and covered it with its handkerchief, but the blood was not stopped, it is flowing. The king redressed the wound until at last the bleeding stopped. Yes, Here the situation was very horrible. The king was digging the earth. The hermit stood there and he was asking again, repeat the questions. But 1 hour passed. Already 1 hour has been completed. Again 1 more hour, 2 hour has been completed. The sun went down behind the trees. What does it mean? The sun went down behind the trees. It is about sunset. Okay, it is about dark. It is about getting the night. And last, the king stuck the spade into the ground and said, I came to you, wise man, to get answers to my question. If you can now give answer, I will return my home. What king here did it? Just he was digging the earth. It is about night time. Again, the king just stuck the spade on his ground and he asked the question. My dear hermit, I came you to clarify my doubts. I have a questions. If you no give answer, I'll just return my home back. If you say so, definitely I return my home. Here comes someone running. Yes, when the both were speaking each other, there was one more strange person who is running towards the hermit and king. And here the hermit was noticing him. Somebody coming towards us. Said the hermit. The king turned round and saw a bearded man running towards them. Yes, there was a person who had a beard. Beard, I think you know that. Bearded man is coming towards them. His hands were pressed against his stomach. The bearded man just was holding his stomach and he was pressing his stomach because from which the blood was flowing. It was unbelievable. The bearded man who was coming towards them just hold his hand on his stomach and he was coming towards them because by his stomach the blood was flowing. It was bleeding. When he reached the king, he fainted and fell to the ground. When he reached the king, he was fainted. Here the meaning of faint. Fainted means unconscious. Just he got unconscious and he was fell down. It is natural thing that. So when the blood was flowing much from our body, definitely we get unconscious. We will be unconscious. He was fainted. Fainted means unconscious. He was unconscious and fell down on the ground. The king and the hermit removed the man's clothing and found a large wound in his stomach. What they did it? Just removed his shirt. And what they did it? See, the king washed and covered it with his handkerchief. The king, what they did it? Just he washed all the, mud and something. Just he washed the blood and he was dressed with his handkerchief. But the blood would not stop flowing. But also he got, much wound on his stomach. So he just dressed it, but it was not stopped. It was flowing. The bleeding again. The bleeding has continued. The king redressed the wound until at last the bleeding stopped. What he did it? Again he redressed it. Again he folded it. Different folds, beds. At last the blood was stopped. The man closed his eyes, lay quiet. The king, tired by his walk and work he had done, lay down on the floor and slept through the night. When he woke up, it was several minutes before he could remember where he was or who the strange bearded man laying on the bed was. Yes, the man has closed his eyes. As I noticed here, the bearded man, he lost his strength because of bleeding. He was about unconscious. Just he lay down on the floor. Now, the bearded man was laid down. The meaning of this statement, just he was went to the unconscious or he slept. Here again the king, he was tired because of walk. Because he is the one who came by walk, by the food. So later, by the work, the king was very tired. He lay on down the floor. Again the king got sleep. The king also slept. Lay down on the floor and slept through the night. At night, he did not remember what happened because of tiredness. It is a gradual thing. It is basically human being when we mentally and physically strain, usually we will be nervous. What we need? Just we need to eat something and we need to go to the bed. Nothing we need. Okay. So when human being get tired, just we need to be go to the rest or need to be sleep. As it is here, being a king, he was very tired because of his walk and because of his work. He got tired and just he lay down on the floor at fully night. When he woke up, it was several minutes before he could remember what he was or what the strange bearded man laying on this bed was. So after several minutes of woke up, just he noticed that where I am, who I am, why I am here. He remembering that, oh, yesterday evening there was a person who came to us, that bearded man. He was, you know, bleeding, he got wound and it was bleeding. We are the one who just dressed up and just he lay down, he fainted, he unconscious. He was remembering all those things what happened in last today. Because of his nervousness, just he slept down. He came to a present status where he was. In 7th paragraph, "Forgive me," said the bearded man in a weak voice when he saw that the king was awake. Yeah, forgive me. Here, this is a statement stated by whom? By a bearded man. Bearded man is asking sorry to the king. The bearded man is asking sorry to the king. What? "Forgive me," said the bearded man in a weak voice when he saw that the king was awake. Okay, when king awake, the bearded man looked at him and he is asking forgiveness. "Could you please forgive me?" Your bearded man asking king to the forgive. I don't know you and have nothing to forgive you for," said the king. "I don't know who are you. Just I helped you. Why you are asking me forgiveness? I don't know actually who are you. What's your mistake?" Here the king got shocked and he was asking, he was inquiring. "You do not know me, but I know you. I am the enemy of yours who swore revenge on you because you put my brothers to death and seized my property. I had made up my mind to kill you on your way home. You don't know who am I, but I know who you are. You are the king. I made my mind to kill you because I am one of your enemy. Okay, because you are the one who killed my brothers and you are the one who seized my property. I made my mind to kill you." Okay. Here what happened? The bearded man is none other than he was the enemy of king. But here unusual events. What is the unusual events here? King, he doesn't know who is he. The bearded man, he know who is he. But the king just he saved his life. This is called unusual event. "I have made up my mind to kill you on your home. But the day passed and you did not return. So I left my hiding place and I came upon your bodyguard who recognized me and wounded me. I escaped from him, but I should have died if you had not dressed my wounds." Here the bearded man was explaining that, "My dear majesty, you don't know who am I, but I know who you are. I am one of your enemy. You are the one who killed my brothers and seized our property. So that is why I decided that I need to kill you. On the day when you came out from the home, I hid in a place and I about to kill while you were returning home, returning palace, but you did not return. Just I jumped from that hiding place. While I was going my path, your bodyguard recognized me and he wounded me. He tried to kill me, but I was escaped from him. I came to you. Unknowingly I came to you, but you are the one who saved my life. This is called unusual events. Okay. I should have died if you had not dressed my wounds. Definitely you are the one who saved my life by dressing the cloth. Now if I live, I will serve you as your most faithful servant. Definitely I promise you, my dear king, you are the one who saved my life. If you agree that I serve you until last of my breath, I will be your servant." So what did you understand by this statement. As I have mentioned that these are not unusual events. Unknowingly we would have helped something. We don't know, he may be our enemy. So now I have a question that, just you think it, if a king knew he is the enemy of king, whether he would have helped him? Think it. Okay, and you have to answer me in next video. We will continue this session in next class. Okay, students?